Hello everyone, welcome back to engineering chemistry class. Today we'll discuss solar cells, different types of solar cells, construction working of solar cells, and finally we'll discuss about advantages and disadvantages. It is estimated that Earth receives solar energy almost equivalent to 20 into 10 to the power of 20 kilojoules annually. This is almost 10,000 times more than the requirement. This solar energy is the only one energy that fulfills our present and future energy needs if we utilize properly. Solar energy can be directly converted into heat energy or electricity. The device which converts solar energy to electrical energy is known as solar cell. These solar cells are broadly classified as inorganic solar cells, organic solar cells, disensitized solar cells. Among them, inorganic solar cells are currently used in market. Amorphous based solar silicon cells are classified under inorganic solar cells. Now we will discuss amorphous based solar silicon cells. It is based on photovoltaic effects. The picture shows a typical solar cells. It consists of N-type and P-type material made up of silicon. In the fabrication of device, these N-type and P-type materials are joined. On the top of N-type, front electrodes are placed. In between these front electrodes, anti-reflective material is used in order to avoid the reflection of sunlight. Finally, these N-type and P-type layers are joined externally to the circuits. Working. When sunlight is incident on solar cells, photon strikes on p-n junction, then electron hole pair will be created at the junction by the absorption of photon. This electron hole pair diffuses towards respective layer based on their affinity. The electron diffuses towards n-type layer, whereas holes diffuse towards p-type layer. These layers are connected externally through a circuit, hence current will be generated. This cycle is repeated whenever sunlight falls on the N-type material. Let us see a few advantages of solar cells. Solar energy is environmentally friendly and green energy because it does not produce any greenhouse gases and no pollutants. Solar cell is renewable energy which can be continuously drawn from the sun. Let us see a few disadvantages of solar cells. These type of solar cells require large area for installation. It requires high investment cost for a big power plant, and we can't generate all 365 days in a year, especially in rainy seasons. In order to overcome this, we will go for disensitized solar cells. It consists of two electrodes, anode and cathode. Cathode is made up of platinum or graphite. Anode is transparent conducting oxide such as indium tin oxide. Anode material is coated with a layer of nanoporous material such as zinc oxide or titanium dioxide. Further, these nanoporous material coated with light absorbing organic or inorganic dye molecules, it may be ruthenium complexes. In between these two electrodes, triiodide is used, which helps in electron transfer process. Now let us see the working of disensitized solar cells. When sunlight falls on the solar cell, it passes through indium titanium dioxide. Working. When sunlight falls on the solar cell, it passes through indium tin oxide and reaches dye molecules. Dye molecules undergo excitation with the liberation of electrons, which travels through a network of titanium dioxide, finally reaches cathode. The electron from cathode reduces triiodide molecule to 3 iodide molecules. Further, these iodide molecules reaches dye molecules, oxidizes to form triiodide with the liberation of electrons. The liberated electrons are absorbed by dye molecules. This cycle continues whenever sunlight falls. Let us see few advantages of dye solar cell. Processing and fabrication can be done at room temperature. Material cost is minimum and operation is simple. If you look at the disadvantages, stability of dye is difficult. Then handling of liquid electrode is difficult. This type of solar cells are used usually in power grids and flexible solar cells, even in military applications.